Let us center our hearts in prayer. O Holy One, help us to become masters of ourselves so that we might become the servants of others. Take our minds and think with them. Take our lips and speak through them. Take our hands and work with them, and take our hearts and set them on fire. This afternoon, we have heard just a few of the many wonderful stories about Maurine. It is impossible to capture in a few words all that she was. When I met with Ed and members of the family to craft this memorial service, I offered up several possible scripture passages. When I read Paul's letter, Ed said, "That's it. That's Maurine." So along with the attributes we have heard, we must underscore patience, kindness, love. Neither was she envious or rude, and she certainly did not insist on her own way. Ed was with the Army for 21 years, and Russ, 20 times? 20 times in 21 years. That means you move a lot. Washington State, Virginia, California, New York State, Germany, Illinois, New York City on Governor's Island, Okinawa. Maurine was also challenged by Ed's absence, serving in Korea, serving in Vietnam twice, as well as his being on the road a lot for his job. How would our generation fare under such circumstances? Not so well. Love bears all things. I could get really serious here, but I'm struck with one anecdote that Ed told me about, and that is when Ed and Maurine vacation in Italy, camping with two kids in a tent, and it rained the whole time. Imagine having to wash cloth diapers and trying to dry them on a clothesline. Talk about bearing all things. I would be crabby. Love never ends. Ed and Maurine, this was a love story. They were introduced at a sorority party by a fraternity brother of Ed's and a sorority sister of hers, Mickey and Jack Dunn, who got married and became lifelong friends. Maurine at the time was a sophomore and he was a senior. They both attended Oregon State. And as Ed says, they just clicked. After she graduated, they got married. Maurine was the love of his life. 59 years. They had hoped to celebrate their 60th together. Maurine was a gift from God. She was a beautiful example of how the blessings of God are continually unfolding. How else to explain this gift of quilting that only was revealed later in her life? Now, with the wisdom of perspective and years, we can see how the seeds of this ministry were planted early on. As we have heard, her father died some weeks before her birth. She did have two brothers, much older than herself, and so, frankly, it was just her and her mother. Her mother sewed, and that is where she learned the craft. Years later, she was asked to cover for a teacher at Edmonds Junior College and finish the class teaching quilting. She learned as she went. And she offered up the novel idea of sewing quilts on a machine. This was sacrilegious at the time. It took off. 3 books later, a national teacher. And a teacher to the end, may I say, Patricia mentioned how she loved to teach. And indeed, on August 8th, June and May and I were going to be taught our first lesson with Maurine on August 8th. She was an artist, but more than that, hear these words, the most visible creators I know of are those artists whose medium is life itself. The ones who express the inexpressible without brush, hammer, clay, guitar, or sewing machine. They neither paint nor sculpt, their medium is being. Whatever their presence touches has increased life. They see and don't have to draw. They are the artists of being alive. Yes, indeed, the last 5 years of Maureen's life, she was in incredible pain. She endured, I thought, 6, but here I hear from Patricia, 7 surgeries. But despite all this, her life is a testimony to all of us that the pain and limitations that we may suffer do not have to claim, define, and become our identity. And in the midst of all this, Ed took care of her in every aspect. Love hopes all things. Yes, Maureen was conscious until some 20 minutes before she passed. And indeed, as Patricia shared, she said, I don't want to die. Because she has so much more to live for. She had so many more adventures and things that she wanted to accomplish. How remarkable. May it be so for each one of us. But there is so much more. Did you know that Jesus never attended a funeral? Never did. He loved weddings, but he never attended funerals. I think that's appropriate. I think that's appropriate when you think about it, because Jesus rolls away every stone, even the stones of disease and death. So in faith we know that death is not the failure of her therapy, the failure of modern medicine. It is not a closed door, but a threshold to a world where there is no pain. And our hearts are filled with unlimited joy. Death is blowing out the candle because the dawn has come. Thanks be to God. Now, won't you please join me in our prayer of thanksgiving and intercession as it is printed in the Bible. Let us all pray. Through all the various scenes of life, We commend your servant, Maurine. Acknowledge, we humbly pray, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own fold, and a daughter of your own redeemed. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the company of the saints of light. Amen. And now let us go in peace, in the knowledge that in the goodness of God, we were created. By the grace of God through Jesus Christ, we are liberated. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, we are kept all the day long. Amen. Please remain seated for the twirling knot.